Chapter 11, Section 5, Bonds. Corporations can sell shares of stock to raise funds. Shares represent ownership in the corporation. However, managers sometimes prefer to borrow money rather than issue stock. They borrow money for short-term needs from banks or insurance companies. Managers also can make long-term loans with banks, but they often prefer to borrow for the long term by issuing bonds. Bonds are legally binding promises or contracts to repay borrowed money at a specified date in the future. Here's a graph of how companies can raise money. Corporate profits from the business. They can sell stocks so that they have ownership. Shares represent ownership in the corporation, or they can borrow the money, as we said, either from a bank loan or issuing bonds. Corporations commonly pay interest on each bond each year. Unlike shareholders, bondholders do not own part of the corporation. Other entities, including countries, cities, and even churches, also borrow money by using bonds. And you'll hear this when a school has a building project or a municipality with a swimming pool. You'll hear that they're issuing bonds. So let's read a bond table. The face value or par value of a bond is the original amount of money borrowed by the company. Most public corporations issue bonds with a par value of $1,000. Principal and any interest due must be paid when a bond matures. Because the bond has value to it, they can be bought and sold. The price is driven by the market conditions at the time the bond is sold. And here we have a bond table. The first column is showing us the ticker symbol. In this case, it's Walmart, which the ticker symbol is WMT. The next column is showing us coupon rate. This is actually the annual interest rate per bond. And it's a percentage, so it's 3.375% of the typical bond value, $1,000. So to determine an annual interest rate, we take 1,000 times this percent to give us the interest earned on buying a bond. The next column is maturity. This is the date that the bond matures, at which time Walmart must pay it off. The next column is the last price at which the bond was traded, and this is a percentage of 1,000. So we could do our calculation here. $1,000 times this percentage shows us how much Walmart would receive for this $1,000 bond. And a note here that the price of bonds do fluctuate based on the current lending rates. Next, we have the last yield. An investor holding the bond until its maturity date would earn 3.508% per year on this investment. This is often called the yield of maturity. This yield is determined by the current price, the maturity value of bond, time to maturity, and all of the interest payments made between now and the maturity date. The last column in our bond table is showing us the estimated volume of this bond that's sold during the week. And this is in thousands with the three zeros here. So we would take that number from the table, times it by 1,000, and this would be the amount of money that Walmart's bonds sold for in the past week. While we look at buying and selling bonds, charges may vary from one broker to the other. However, it's common that there is a $10 per bond when they are either bought or sold, similar to paying a commission when purchasing stocks. So let's take a look at calculating the purchase of buying a bond. This is showing us the Allied Waste of North America and showing us that the last price was 106.5% of 1,000. So we take that percentage, timesing it by 1,000. This is what we would pay to purchase this bond. How many bonds were sold during the week? We take our number here indicated in the last column and times it by 1,000. This is the amount of money that this bond sold during the past week. When is this bond going to mature? In other words, when will Allied Waste of North America have to pay off this bond? And the maturity date is here in the third column, May 15th of 2016. How do we calculate the annual interest rate paid per bond? We're going to look at the coupon, and the coupon value has 7.125, but that's a percentage. And to calculate the actual dollar amount of interest, we take our rate times the principal or the value of the bond, 1,000, to give us an annual interest amount of $71.25. Next, let's take a look at what the last yield or yield to maturity is. This is given here on the table, last yield, but it's interpreted as a percentage. If the investor is holding the bond until its maturity date, they would earn 4.749% per year on their investment. And again, this is often called yield to maturity. Next, let's calculate the price to buy 50 of these bonds, including sales charge of $10 per bond. We need to be looking at the last price here. This is a percentage. So to calculate our total cost, we need to find our price per bond. That ends up being $1,065. We're taking our last price, which is a percentage of the face value or the par value of the bond, 1,000, gives us $1,065. They're telling us that there is a sales charge of $10 for the transaction of purchasing it. So we'll add that on, $1,075. And since they're buying 50 of these, we multiply by 50. So this would be the cost of the investor to purchase 50 of these Allied Waste of North America bonds. Let's look at another example. Assuming the sales charge is $10 per bond, compute the total cost of purchasing 30 bonds of GMAC. Well, GMAC is General Motors Acceptance. We're going to look at that last price again. That is a percentage, and we multiply that percentage by the par value of the bond, 1,000. But we need to add on our sales charge of $10 per bond. So we'll bump our price per bond up by $10. So $1,061.54 times the number of bonds gives us $31,846.20. This is our price or our total cost for the purchase of 30 bonds. What kind of interest is earned on this investment? So let's compute the total annual interest paid on the 30 bonds. So we're looking at our interest rate. That's under our coupon category. This is the annual interest paid per bond. It is a percentage. So we'll take the 6.875% times the par value or face value of the bond. That'll give us the annual interest per bond, but this individual owns 30 bonds, giving us a total interest or income for this investment and purchase of these bonds. You're essentially setting yourself up as a lender to this company. of $2,062.50. Most bonds are subject to tax. There are some exceptions when it's a governmental issued bond. Perhaps a municipality would fall into that category. So what is your actual return on this investment? So this next slide is asking us to compute the effective interest rate to the buyer, including the cost of buying the bonds. So total interest we just calculated in the previous slide. We calculated the total cost of the bonds in the slide before when we purchased the 30. And to find the effective interest rate, we will take our total interest, that's the money that was gained for this investment, divided by the cost of this investment to give us an effective interest rate return of almost 6.5%.